Hi guys, Linda here. I kind of slept in and I'm on my second cup of coffee. That's all I drink, is two cups. When I do drink it, I usually drink tea. But I was reading, I go to the internet and check out the web and read articles, and I came across this Federal Way Washington police officer beat the crap out of, it sounds like several of them did, beat the crap out of a handicapped woman. And I'm going to first show you the Federal Way police officer's website. And maybe we can do some phone calling and get this thing right, because everything that happened to this woman was totally wrong. She was handicapped, she was hard of hearing. So here we go. Okay. I'm assuming this guy right here is the chief of police of the Federal Way Police Department. I will show you that I am on the Federal Way Police Department. Let me see if I can go down here. I want to show you phone numbers. Let's get this close up. We need to make phone calls really seriously. Okay. Now, it'll tell you blah, blah, blah up here about them, but here's their guiding principles. Do you see that? Accountability, communication, integrity, respect, and teamwork. Which they follow none of the above except teamwork on beating the hell out of a woman. Now, this is a picture of the woman. Federal Way woman calls 911 during an arrest. This is what the police did to a handicapped woman. I will briefly read what they did. Federal Way Police were reviewing their use of force during a recent arrest in which a woman diagnosed with cognitive and hearing disabilities was punched several times and being restrained. Police in turn are recommending the woman be charged with felony assault to an officer. Let's go back over to that face. She is going to be charged with felony assault to an officer. This is pretty typical of Federal Way. I'm going to go out a little bit. Megan Graham, who told her story to Cairo 7 News, her face still black and blue, swollen from the beating. I had a concussion. I still have a hard time understanding how things got so out of control so fast, Graham said. I was a total lack of communication. Last Monday, Megan Graham parked her car at a Federal Way apartment complex where she was planning to visit a friend. She said she was getting out of her car. She noticed a Federal Way police car behind her. I understood that he saw me using the cell phone. I told the officer I was going to carry my dog 30 feet to a friend's apartment. I told him, hey, you can walk with me, she said. Graham said, because the officer was speaking to her from his running car, she never heard his order to get back into the car. When the officer lunged and grabbed her wrist, she felt that she was being attacked. Well, she was. I pulled my arm back and grabbed my phone and called 911 to help, or 911 to call for help. She said, I told the officer I had a mental and hearing disabilities and didn't understand why he was trying to hurt me. In the 9/11 recordings obtained by Cairo 7, Graham is heard pleading this dispatcher for help. I was hoping other officers would show up to listen and de-escalate the situation, Graham said. In the 9/11 recording, Graham shouts at the officer, you attacked me before you said anything. There is no point whatsoever for you to touch me like that, especially with my condition. So how dare you even touch me? The officer is clearly heard repeating, you are under arrest. During the 9/11 call, a responding officer punched Graham several times in the face and is heard loudly ordering her repeatedly to stop resisting. I'm not resisting, replied Graham. Graham said when the officer put his weight, of course, you know how they like to put all their weight on a person, weight on her hip, which she says was previously injured, she reacted by trying to flip over, as we all would. Federal Way Police said she assaulted an officer during that struggle. My goodness, she was in pain. Her face had just been beat in. That woman was not resisting. I saw it, said Graham's friend, Deborah Fenwick, who saw the takedown. The woman doesn't have a violent bone in her body. She's got a heart of gold. If she would have understood the officer's commands in the first place, she would have absolutely complied with him, Fenwick said. In an email to Cairo 7, a Federal Police spokesperson provided the officer's narrative of the struggle. As the officer approached, Graham squared off against him in a fighter stance. Now remember, she's got a dog in her arm, okay? So she squared against him in a fighter stance and attempted to strike him with closed fists. Well, that story's not holding up. The officer responsible with closed fists to Graham's face responded with closed fists to Graham's face, which brought her to the ground where she was handcuffed, the officer wrote. It was horrible. I just don't understand any of it, said Graham, who denies trying to hit the officer. I told him about my condition. Punching me over and over in the eye is obviously excessive force. He could have handled it differently, Graham said. This is an outrage, so I suggest we just start calling and putting our point of view up. This is Linda out. I'm going to leave this up, and let's do something about this.